daughter Elizabeth.
Hello.
I've seen me around school. I know you may know. I was diagnosed with a neurological disorder roughly 10 years ago. And that time, kids are toddlers. So, and my family kind of, and I yelled at me and preached to me that I couldn't just sit there and give up. And kids that depend on me looked up to me. And, when I was growing up, my father volunteered a lot for different things around town. But me being a father and having young kids, I started volunteering at school. I started volunteering roughly 4 years ago in my son's class when he was in secondary. And I mean, the first time I walked in the building, like, you've seen cartoons where they have the bubbles. I could read their thoughts like, whoa, a dancer. You don't see that because you see mom and my grandma's. Well, I started, you know, like I said, volunteering with my son's class for doing their ER test, reading, stuff like that. I found it very rewarding to see kids would give me smiles or high fives and all. And tell them there's more to life than just going out and making money. Seeing that I'm disabled, I didn't really want to work around the power sauce. Butcher, I might hurt myself. So I applied for disability. That way I could stay home, raise the kids, take them to school, pick them up, whatever. And of course, I help out the homework. When I started helping out at school, kind of helped me. Kind of like a quick explain when kids come up and say what's wrong with their. See me and all, say hi, Miss Irvin, or Nick's dad, or Elizabeth's dad. And parents are kind of like, who's that guy? And they would ask the kids, and kind of made me feel good they accepted me. And Elizabeth, my daughter, who used to be a cheerleader for 6 years. So I got to know some more parents of the girls, and then some of them, my younger siblings, where I saw them in school, or I would see the parents also at conferences. So they would come, or they would acknowledge me, come say hi. Because volunteering in class, or my son's class, then they started that watchdog program. Are you guys familiar with that? I started doing that roughly, well, the first year I did it like 12 times, because I don't work. So, and the kids really love seeing me in class. And like I said, they got to know me. The ones that don't know me. Yeah, one of my first days of doing a lot of volunteering, walked in this fourth grade class, and this young girl, I'm not sure, don't remember her name, I call her Patty, but she asked why I walk so funny. So, being the first time I volunteered there, I wasn't sure what to say. Then a neighbor kid of mine, yeah, Landon, stood up and explained to him, all that he said it's difficult for him to walk, he had something wrong with his legs. And I was so shocked that somebody would get up and say that and defend me. I was so proud because, like I said, he was my neighbor, so I went home, told his mother how proud I was of him. That, I don't know, what his mama do, give him a treat or whatever, take him to McDonald's. That's what I do with my son. But also, thanks to Landon, I kind of have a better way of explaining my disability in a short sentence. So a lot of people thought I had Parkinson's or cystic fibrosis or stuff like that. No, something completely different. It took the doctor 4 to 5 years to figure out what I had. But the only thing that really hurts me is my pride. But doing the many volunteer jobs I do, it makes me feel better. I can help out society. And like I said, getting smiles from you guys helps make me feel much better. Yeah, when I volunteered on my daughter's class, we used Chromebooks, you know what those are?
Yeah.
And they were playing, yeah, math was up. So I logged in, and all of a sudden he saw my name up on the board, and they're wondering, who's Alan? So looking all over, of course my daughter knew. His teacher also knew, because they go to church with her. And once I learned who it was, they were trying to look all over for me, and I was in the back class. It's kind of fun to participate with the class. Do you guys know Mr. Davis, though?
Yeah, I'm in his class.
Okay. Well, one time I volunteered, he was out, and the substitute never showed up. So, his, his wife, Miss Davis?
Yeah, the art teacher.
Yeah. By the time she was just a regular teacher. And she came in, and her class was next door, so she could oversee. And told me to let them do some kind of program on the Chromebooks to kind of oversee. So it kind of made me feel like a teacher. Teacher's aid. And one girl whose mother I went to school with many years ago came up, told me what the teacher does normally, so I had an idea. Some of the other kids came up to me and says, come and use the Chromebooks in the hallway. So as far as I know, I told them, as long as you're not loud, go ahead. So just like I said, it made me feel like a teacher's assistant, made me feel good. other experience I had was in Miss Murdoch's class, you know her? Yeah, she's good. But anyways, she had a new student come in. And she had me take that student down to the library to fill out papers and kind of catch up some of the work. I don't remember her name exactly, but I call her Susie. She just loved the one-on-one attention I gave her. And like I said, I'm no teacher, but I did the best I could being a parent. And also when I was doing the hot dog in the fifth grade, when Mr. Diebel, you remember him?
He's retired.
Well, yeah, he's retired, but he was a gym teacher at that time, a couple years ago. And I walked in, well, since I walked with Kane, I just kind of sat and observed. And all of a sudden, some young boy says, "Hey, I know your father." I'm thinking, "Oh, so you know my dad?" He's my, his dad and uncle used to live across the street from my mom and dad. Took me a while to figure that one out. So I'm so used to being called Nick's dad or Elizabeth's dad, but no one minded, and that was weird. I also tried to volunteer at a church's Acacia Bible School. The first year I did, which was 3 years ago, three to 4 years ago. I was walking better, so I didn't use a cane so much. I walked or led 12 preschoolers around the different stations. And of course, being my first year as a kid, I didn't know what it was. Kind of grabbed my hand, made me feel a little more confident, seeing it was my first year as well as his. So I don't know if the kids learned any Bible stories being so young, but hopefully they saw me trying to do my best, even though I have a disability. Because of all the volunteering I do, one of the teachers, Mr. Shenderson, you know him?
Oh, yeah,
he was coming around and says, "Oh, there's the volunteer of the year." Since I volunteer so much. Because my daughter had him one year, my son had him the next year, so I volunteered in their class to help out on that. Again, it just helped me feel confident helping them with homework and helping out regularly. I share these stories with them, kind of explain there's a lot more to do in life if you're disabled or just if you're not working. Gives you something to do, keeps your mind active, and also we gotta get back to the youth. I've also volunteered here and down quite a bit, but I like volunteering at church or at the school with the kids. So like I said, it's nice to see the smiles or the high fives or just recognition. disabled or something wrong with it. Because, I mean, you can't do a job, who knows, you might be able to do it better than somebody else. And it's taught me a lot, and it still does teach me a lot. Especially still having young kids in school. I mean, they're not your age anymore, but I like doing it. I don't self-compete, no, I volunteer.
I mean, do you volunteer?
Yes, I do the homework, pull up like Braxton was saying.
No,
the homework, and that's about it. Anything else? Meet a lot of people, kids and adults, and also get along or get teachers know who I am, especially when my kids are younger. Trips, I mean, yeah, you go camping with the kids and go to, yeah, McDonald's, we go other places. And then go to the gym. So, I don't want to just sit around. Yeah, pretty much. Just like my dad, he doesn't want to sit around. He does that, I guess, but he's not one to sit around for 5 minutes. Does that answer your question? Okay. Anybody else? Yeah?
Oh. Is there anything with disability that's hard for you to do?
Walking? I cannot run. Well, I'm going to try, but seeing I have a problem walking, I don't want to try it with running.
Okay.
Yeah?
Well, what special are you best at?
Are you referring to like PE or art?
Yeah.
Oh, he's referring to like specialists.
Pretty much man.
Man.
Because I was a good math back in the day.
Just your different maths we talk about at our house, because I was raised the old way of doing math. I don't really understand Common Core, so everything he's relating to math right now. Interesting.
That's another reason I volunteered to try to see what they do for Common Core.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Isn't it fun?
Yeah.
It's a good time, isn't it, parents?
Yeah, especially
no.
When you get a teacher.
Oh, I emailed the teacher every other day about it, so yeah, she's got to love me, but it's interesting.
Our teacher in love
always felt. Mm-hmm. Another question?
Does your daughter want to ask a question?
Well, ask a question to her. Well, you can ask her. Her name's Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, always do like me.
Wait, what?
Come closer.